Hello and welcome. I'm honored to announce that Voluson Ultrasound has turned 20 and we cannot contain our excitement. This journey has been a legacy of innovation and patient impact that began 20 years ago when Voluson Women's Health Ultrasound joined the GE family. Working with you and other physicians around the world, we have improved women's lives and ensured better health for generations. Voluson is known for its innovative technologies and easy workflows. It is also a global market leader in women's health ultrasound, thanks to your love, support, and partnership. To celebrate this anniversary, we have created a web series called The Voice of Voluson, which recognizes the change makers in women's health in South Asia. Follow these stories of remarkable physicians who transformed care and inspired us to always aim higher, be bolder, and think bigger. Fetal heart echo is undoubtedly one of the most complex diagnoses. One out of 110 babies born worldwide have a heart defect, and detection rates even in low-risk pregnancies are less than 50%. This eminent expert wanted to change that. We are honored to have Dr. Balu Vaidyanathan, Professor, Pediatric Cardiology, Head Fetal Cardiology Division, Amrita Institute of Medical Sciences, Kochi, Kerala. In today's episode, we will join Dr. Balu Vaidyanathan as he talks about his quest for achieving excellence in fetal echo and shifting it from being a profession to passion, and the enormous steps and trainings undertaken by him to provide hope to patients and babies born with fetal heart defect. A truly inspiring story. Let's watch it.
I come from a family with a very rich background in medicine. Both my parents are doctors. This whole journey, which is now about 33 years old in medicine, but the whole situation was very different. I started from my MBBS from Medical College Kottayam, a government medical college. This was in 1988. That time, there was a very minimal understanding about many of the things which I'm doing now, like fetal echo. I don't think there was any such thing was discussed in our teaching sessions. In fact, even when a baby with a heart defect was diagnosed, they had very minimal options for surgery and referral to a surgical center and so on. So that is how we began. After that, after my MBBS, I actually pursued my post-graduation in pediatrics from All India Institute of Medical Sciences. And there I got, of course, more exposure towards heart defects in children. Yet there wasn't much discussions about fetal echo and all, even during that period. Then I actually joined for my cardiology training from Sri Chitra Institute in Trivandrum. That was my fellowship in cardiology. Even then, the most of the focus was on the child after birth, and we used to mostly discuss that. So what I wanted to say is that the prenatal diagnosis of congenital heart defects, at least in the cardiology community, was a relatively unknown entity during most of my training. So for that, actually, I have to go back to 2007. where I actually got a Commonwealth Fellowship to train in fetal cardiology from Evelina Children's Hospital, London. And that's where I actually got my real exposure to fetal echocardiography and fetal cardiology. So there I was initiated towards the specific protocol-based imaging of the fetal heart. And then we came back to India in 2008 and I initiated a program in my center, which is in Amrita Institute of Medical Sciences. Initially, we were actually, doing this as a part of the busy pediatric cardiac practice. But later on, we realized that this is a completely a niche specialty. It deserves its own attention and a complete, comprehensive team, including fetal medicine, genetics, and so on. And we started moving towards that goal. And from 2015 onwards, we have a completely comprehensive program in place. And that is where we got our first Voluson machine, that is Voluson E10, which was purchased in 2015. And then I really realized that, how much forward and how much further we can go, learn more and more, and then we reach the point where we are right now. So we set about, building up awareness in the community in Kerala about, prenatal screening of the fetal heart, which was sort of there, but not many people were adhering to the protocols. Many people felt that fetal heart is something which is very difficult. It is beyond, a normal obstetrician's, a normal radiologist's capability. So we actually partnered with several societies like the Obstetric Society and then the Radiology Societies, Fetal Medicine Societies, and of course the ultrasound industry and Voluson and GE company supported a lot of these programs in training the doctors. After that, the key change came when the government of Kerala decided to take up a policy for pediatric heart care. Now in Kerala, we have a dedicated government program which provides all heart surgeries to everyone in Kerala free of cost. So as a part of this program, this is called the Hrudyam program. Hrudyam is called heart. One of the components of this program was the training of obstetricians and radiologists in fetal heart screening. And we trained more than 500 doctors. This was the pre-COVID period, 2017 and 18, and we brought about a significant change in the pickup rates of heart defects whilst in utero. So a lot of people started referring critical heart defects while the baby is in utero towards tertiary center for delivery in the tertiary center and postnatal care. And through a number of publications over the last 5 years, the data was presented in various forums. And now we have shown the benefits of such strategy. It shows a tremendous benefit to patient outcomes. The mortality and morbidity after newborn heart surgery significantly improved. And the cost of care also became lesser because the number of hospitals, the transport, etc. were avoided. And one of the reasons why Kerala could achieve a single digit infant mortality rate was the radical change in the way we look at critical heart defects and how we manage them. Because there was a study by the Indian Academy of Pediatrics which showed that one of the major reasons for infant mortality in Kerala was birth defects of the heart. So this whole journey happened over a period of a decade. So a lot of partners were there for us, including our other professionals like obstetricians, radiologists, fetal medicine people. We partnered with all their societies. We partnered with the government of Kerala. We partnered with the several NGOs providing financial and supportive care. And of course, we also partnered with our ultrasound company specialists, particularly the Voluson group, by providing them the support for actually many of these training programs. Of course, our own equipment helped us to get these pristine pictures with so much clarity and confidence that, the counseling and planning the peripartum care was done in a very, very, very systematic manner. Looking at the fetal heart from a surgical perspective, from the what will we do after the baby is born, that is a completely different standard. There we need a lot of very fine anatomical details which the surgeon will require. And this will help and this will decide what type of surgery will be done, what is the expected outcome, whether it will be one surgery or more than one surgery and so on. And this is where a really, really high-end equipment with expertise helps. And this is where we have shown that the 3D, 4D technology is immensely helpful. So we have used this technology for several complex defects. What we typically do is we acquire volume data sets And then after the study is over, we do the post-processing. We look at planes which were not usually seen by the conventional 2D imaging. Then we actually run through the volume data sets. We can show the volume data sets to the surgeon, and that we can actually create the rendered pictures using the multiple planes and actually create a kind of a model for the surgeon to see, in which, okay, this is a heart, how, what will you do? And then we can discuss what will be the specific surgery, and all this information can go back to the parents when we counsel. And this will immensely help the parents also to take a decision. And that is, and all this is now easily possible between 20 to 22 weeks, around 24 weeks. That's the time when most of this 3D, 4D stick-based rendering is done. And even before that, I know that first trimester fetal echocardiography is being done. I will see that mostly as a tool to pick up some of these very complex defects, which are difficult to treat. And then we can give counseling tips to the families. But as far as getting the anatomical details relevant to surgery, the mid-trimester would be the best time. So we have used this technology into clinical use, the advanced fetal echo technology, and we find exceptional benefit with this technology, and it has helped our practice as well as our patients. The fetal is like an additional engine for us. With the prenatal diagnosis, we are able to counsel and deliver these babies with critical heart defect in our center itself. When the baby is born in the same center, we can start the treatment immediately after birth. Some of the patients have actually gone for surgery within 20 minutes after birth because they were so critical. So all this has been brought about because the diagnostic capability has enhanced. Looking at specific anatomical information and surgical perspective is now possible. And so we can treat this baby sometimes while they are inside the womb itself. So I would say that the ultrasound is something like our eyes to see the baby, and the eyes are getting more and more powerful. The technology is growing with every new iteration of the equipment. More and more features are being brought about. The frame rates are increasing. We have fantastic new probes like the electronic probe, which gives us absolute exquisite imaging. And I feel we lag behind the clinical professionals, but the working with technology has been immensely gratifying. What we do is we have a steady program in which prenatally diagnosed cases come to our center for delivery, and they go for surgery immediately after birth. We have done this about 600 times over the past 10 years. Every year something like 75 such critical babies are delivered and they go for treatment. I would say a couple of situations which are I think I will remember for a very long time. One was a case which came from, I think, Orissa. And this was a very critical heart defect called anomalous pulmonary vein drainage. And they were advised termination, but the family was very keen to treat this baby. And when I saw them at around 22 weeks, I could see that this is a very critical problem. So they stayed back in Cochin from 22 weeks pregnancy till the delivery. After the baby was born, the baby was so sick that immediately had to be put on ventilator. And on ventilator, the oxygen saturation was so low that within 30 minutes after delivery, the baby was shifted to the operating room. And our surgeon operated. The baby went through a very intense post-operative course, a stay of about a month after surgery. But now he celebrated his first birthday and he's doing really, really well. So here, I really believe the technology is helpful because, you know, now the newer equipments have got so many features like the slow flow, you know, and this is like, and then this is unbelievable, you know. And this helps us to look at these tiny little veins. You know, the pulmonary veins in a 20-week fetus are as big as your one hair strand. Sometimes what you do is when you put color, it bleeds all over the place and you can't see this little thing, the structures individually. Now, with this new technology like slow flow, HD flow, etc., you know, you can actually look at each of these veins, these little structures. And then with this rendering thing, like the e-stick, you know, that electronic probe, it just acquires the volume so fast that your frame rates are high, you get high quality volumes, and then you can do the post-processing, determine the entire course and exact anatomy. You know, this is it. This is the key. And I know in my mind, and I'm a pediatric cardiologist, and in my back of my mind, I know that, okay, this baby is really going to be very sick after birth. So I'm prepared. I am prepared. My team is prepared. And I can also prepare the parents that your baby is not going to be with you immediately after birth. it will be taken to the ICU and we will be operating within half an hour. Another case actually was a situation where this happened during the COVID times. A prenatally diagnosed critical heart defect in a COVID positive mother. And this was difficult, obviously, because this was a year back and we had to take a lot of protocols to treat both the baby and the mother because of the COVID situation. But the team was so good that we could actually gel everyone together. And that was a critical heart defect. The baby had to be operated within 2 or 3 days with a lot of special precautions because of the COVID scenario. But the team could pull it off and the baby is now about 9 months and doing very well. So these are two cases which I'll remember, but then there are quite a lot of patients they are all very, very happy. And the prenatal diagnosis, the main advantage is that we are able to tell the families upfront what to expect after birth, when will the operation be done. Everything can be planned so that the stress of going through this difficult period after birth can be significantly reduced by prenatal diagnosis and counseling. And with the new technology, what our equipments have now, the Volusen, the new, what the expert, the E10 series. In fact, the precise details can be imaged even before the baby is born, and the picture after birth will look exactly same. In my presentation for the ISUWAP World Congress, I showed how a stick picture correlates with the postnatal 256 slice CT. Ditto, same. The only difference is CT doesn't have color, stick gives you the color also. Then we were lucky to actually go to the global team in Austria, in Zipf, for a wonderful meeting in 2019, where we met and saw this, how this technology evolved over a long period, and met a lot of people like Ravi Chauvi, who has had a much longer journey with Volusen than me. But nevertheless, what I found very exciting is that finally the interest is all the same, and Volusen also shared this very deep human connect which I have with my patients. So every child is very, very special, and so it is my philosophy that whenever I diagnose a correctable heart disease, I spend maybe 3 times the amount of time I spend for scanning on counseling and arranging the care for these babies. So that is my passion. It is, if you call one passion for me in my life, that's about saving little babies' lives. That's the main thing. So anything which helps me to do that, that is something which is very close to my heart. And I try to avoid things which depress me, negative, things, and also I think cartoons and children's stuff is something which is very interesting. And there's a lot of animation involved, and that is really good. I love a lot of movies like Frozen and the Aladdin, the Pixar, and the Disney creations. They are incredible. I love meeting people in general, and I feel that warmth. And when you train them in person, hold their hand, and inspire them to do things and make them feel good about themselves, their skills. Make them feel, give that belief that they can actually do this. That is where you really, feel great that you are doing something. I think at some point of time, all of us will have to leave and the next generation has to take over. And one of the key things which people like me like to do is to mentor the next generation. So this is what I would like to do in the post-COVID. I would like to get back onto that, road, or rather air, travel, and do some of these programs in real.